At the moment, there is no real understanding on how long plastic can survive at the ocean. My name is Laurent Le Breton and I lead the research department. In ocean plastic research, there is one big question that we have at the moment with ocean plastic. The difference we have between the amount of plastic entering the ocean every year, which may be in the order of several millions of tons per year, and the amount of plastic that we find at the surface of the ocean. That may be like a few hundred thousands of tons of plastic. So one explanation for the missing plastic is what we've been calling the smog theory. Basically, plastic degrades into natural environments, breaks down into little pieces, and sinks at the bottom of the ocean. We believe that the smog is probably existing. There is those little particles going down, but that's not enough to explain like the disappearance of the plastic. Today we present a new model in a scientific report giving another explanation to this difference between input and output. And what we find is that plastic in the surface of the ocean may be actually really highly persistent, but what really removed the plastic is the coastline, the world shoreline. When plastic is released from coastal sources, from your rivers, from the coastline, we expect plastic to actually go back straight onto the land very quickly. And plastic debris may be doing this for, you know, a certain amount of years, like being released into the ocean, captured again by the coastline. And the landmass is basically acting like a filter, keeping a lot of plastic. You may do like this cycle like a few dozens of times before it actually makes its way offshore, right? And this plastic is the ocean plastics we're looking at. This explanation like brings a whole different concept, because what we find is all those little particles and mesoplastic and all those sort of like different bits of plastic floating at the surface of the ocean, we estimate they may actually be really old. Actually, what we're seeing out there at the moment may be more representative of the 80s, of the 90s. So if plastic was degrading very rapidly and disappearing from the sea surface, this plastic should not be at the surface of the ocean. And when we ask the question, where is the missing plastic? Well, it may actually be on its way, and at the moment, we're still not observing it. Using those kind of model, we can try to see like, well, how can we make things better in the future, right? So, you know, we look at business as usual scenario. We can just keep on using plastic, releasing into the ocean. The amount of plastic in the ocean by mid-century may be like four times like as much as what we find right now. But we can just, you know, cut the source, stop plastic to enter the ocean. That's, I think, really important. But what we see is like, if we only do this, then the old plastic, like the accumulated 1 million plus plastic at the surface of the ocean right now, may actually be keep on degrading and creating more and more microplastic. We also look at options to clean up, obviously, and what we find is that we need both measures. It's so important. We need preventive measures, make sure that plastic doesn't enter the ocean, but we also need curative measures. We need to remove plastic waste, accumulated plastic waste, legacy plastic waste from the surface of the ocean. And that's really very much what our model is showing right now, is that we will need a combination of all those measures to really make a dent into the problem and have way less plastic in the next decades than we have right now.